You are is more than just you are by itself. Mm-hmm. We are who we are because of our partners and our engagement and our collaboration.
It's about the customer experience, you know, pre-sale, during sale, post-sale. Are we helping them tackle their challenges?
I get orders, I refuse business, I cannot ship because I don't have enough people.
Hi, my name is Joe Campbell, and I'm here today with the next installment of our Roundtable series. Today's topic, collaborating for excellence. I'm joined by a blue chip panel of automation professionals and really looking forward to today's discussion. First, on my left, I have Sam Bouchard, who's the founder and CEO of UR Plus partner Robotique. Josh Pawley, founding partner, Vectus Automation. Keith Fox, global director of applications for UR. Annelie Dyring-Bro, Global Director of Customer Service for UR, and Stefan Kunstner, Principal with J&K Automation, leading distributor in Germany. Looking forward to a great discussion, folks. So let's get started. I think a key to UR's success has been our ecosystem of partners, both distributors and UR Plus partners and systems integrators. And Sam, let's talk a little bit about your history with Robotique in the UR Plus program. You were one of the very first UR Plus partners, is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. I think we were doing UR Plus and UR Caps before it was even a thing. And then you officially launched this and provided some development tools. So it was in 2017. And when UR unveiled the UR Plus program, we were one of the first ones to show UR Caps and UR Plus products that we did at the same time. So it's been a very fruitful collaboration since. We went from the plug and play components and more recently to application solutions. And it's been a great partnership. But very quickly we realized that UR was a great platform, and it's even more so today because it's a global company, global channel of partners. We can work together. We have a broad portfolio of product to work with and the development tools. And you guys keep investing in the core platform, but also in all the development tools that really allow us to build high performance products, flexible, but also most importantly, easy to use.
So Annelie, how does the customer service team engage with UR Plus partners?
Making sure that we can be with the customer already in the pre-sales phase and then supporting them through then the post-sales process, which is very important, and making sure that they feel supported and have everything they need then in order to make it easy to use, which is also coming down to having then the right training and the right information to support them, the customer, which is very important for us.
I think I really love that too about UR, that it's the cultural meshing that Vectus and UR and Robotique and JK and many other partners, it's about the customer experience, you know, pre-sale, during sale, post-sale. Are we helping them tackle their challenges and boost productivity? I think that's why it's so successful, is that same cultural core value meshing on customer success, really.
Absolutely.
So Keith, you and your team have been all around that space, around the application space, and kind of a bridge with R&D, a bridge with customer service. Give us a little background there, because I think that's a good story too.
Yeah, so we've been able to interact a lot with our partners in the ecosystem, and that for UR, that means a lot, right? UR is more than just UR by itself. Mm-hmm. We are who we are because of our partners and our engagement and our collaboration and the willingness we all have together to help customers to find that solution, right, along their journey. It's been great also in the past 2 years to be able to pull R&D and product management closer to the market, closer to engage with our partner ecosystem as well. You know, because we see this trend of labor, right? And companies not being able to find labor anymore. And so they're looking for more solutions. They want to upskill their workforce. Mm-hmm. We want our customers to not work like robots anymore. We want them to work with robots. Together, collaboratively, we do that for our customers.
We've been talking about the labor shortage for a very long time. It comes from the demography, so everybody saw those pyramid of age and where it would end up. But I think we really reached a tipping point now where it's not only an important problem, but really it became an urgent problem. And especially with the COVID and all the reshuffling of everybody, people may be retiring early. Right now, it's not about reducing the cost of manufacturing. It's about, hey, I cannot produce anymore. I get orders, I refuse business, I cannot ship because I don't have enough people. So it really became an urgent problem. And people who had started to invest early in cobots, they just accelerated recently, and more people are just coming and say, hey, I cannot do this like I've done it in the past. I gotta get going, I gotta start automating.
I couldn't agree more. It's the urgent problem now. And I mean, for decades, automation has been about increasing productivity, financial payback, ROI, cost per piece, and it's still about that. But to your point of it's the urgent problem now, I think over the last year, all the customers that call us, it's, hey, I can't, my bottleneck's welding. I can't get my parts from welding to paint to my customer. And so it became that urgent problem of really more business continuity than it was about financial payback.
And what we see in Germany is not only the lack of labor, but although the expectation of the remaining staff is getting higher and higher, they don't want to do the repetitive jobs anymore. So I think everybody's aching for automation and has to go the one way or the other.
Yeah. And there are a couple of other things with respect to the labor is everybody sees it's the obvious problem is the manual labor shortage, but we don't want to trade that problem for a bigger problem or a tougher problem of finding the automation specialist. So solving the manual task and making it easy to deploy, we need to solve these two problems at the same time. And the other point too that I like to bring with factory owners and managers is it is an opportunity as well, because the people you have, the good people you have, they also want to grow within your company, and learning a new technology, going from welder to welder and maybe programming a robot, same thing for CNC machine tending is the same thing. Really kind of multiplying their impact of the skill, the trade that they know, the welding, the machining, et cetera, and just evolving and keep growing. It's also good for engagement and retaining your people as well.
So, Annelie, customer service plays a pretty key role in that, don't they?
It does.
Yeah.
And for us, it's very important and making sure that we can be part of that actually growth, that people will like them to get more engaged, and we look upon getting more than, say, the knowledge then within that area. So for us, it's important that we do have then the training available to support those guys that go into the automation and making sure that they can grow and getting more competent within that area. That's also why we, through the distribution network, making sure that we have worldwide training facilities as well as online, making sure that we can then educate them from taking the first step and then being more advanced and so forth. So it's an important, definitely. And also then coming back to customer success management, being part of that journey at an early stage, supporting them with all of the questions and with the expert advice from Universal Robots. So it's very, very important for us.
We've just announced a new robot, the UR20.
Yes.
That is terribly exciting for all of us, I think. It was introduced in Germany at Automatica. Could you give us some background on how that evolved and what the reaction was?
It was a really big show. We looked forward a very long time. We've been asked for a bigger cobot for many years now. And I think everybody expected a new product from UR. And so it fit perfect into the market. It was even above my expectations, I have to say. The reach and the payload is really interesting for many customers. And it's not only the reach and the payload, even the speed is increased. And I think that will help for many applications to do higher volumes, which we couldn't handle in the past. And it narrows the gap to the standard industrial robots. I think that's very interesting for many customers.
Sam, you were fortunate. You actually helped develop the first demo that was at Automatica in conjunction with Summit Key's team.
Yeah. So it was a great rush of work we did together. So Keith's team approached us and said, hey, we're about to unveil the robot. Do you want to partner with us to show it doing a real task? And I got to say that the process was very straightforward. And that's one thing I appreciate collaborating with UR. UR has grown, but it's still very entrepreneurial. So, hey, we have something to do. Let's just do it. So it was a great engineering work, great engineering collaboration. But in the end, I think the most interesting thing is that we come to the market together with a real application. So it's not, hey, the robot is ready and the application is going to be ready in 6 months. It's, look, the robot is there and it's ready to work now. So that was really exciting and pretty fun.
Josh, what is it going to do for welding?
For us, it's really about reach, and then is it a weldable, is it an automatable weld joint, right? It's not necessarily going to change the ladder, but the reach really makes a big change, and it just allows a broader portfolio of those boring weldments to be offloaded onto cobots, right? So we're very excited about being able to tackle more applications together and help customers solve more challenges, more weldments with that increased reach.
Annelie, customer service going to be ready?
We will be ready.
Thank you.
So what we are then making sure is that when working closely with product management and R&D, as well as with the distribution network, making sure that they can then have the processes available to support then the particular cobot Euro 20, so that we can do on-site maintenance and repair, as well as we also need to update all of the technical documentation and training. But it comes down to making sure that when we then are starting to ship out the Euro 20, that they also have everything else supporting then the customer.
Yeah, I just say we drove some dynamic change in the market about 15 years ago, and we see it continuing to accelerate. And with Euro 20 launching, our platform coming together, our partnerships getting stronger, I think that's just going to accelerate faster, and the best is yet to come.
I would absolutely agree. And from my perspective, I came from the, as you know, from the traditional side of automation for a long time, and this is a whole brave new world. Very interesting, and I think we're doing a lot of good work. I want to thank all of you for participating. This is a great session, and looking forward to doing it again. Thanks, guys.